Do subscribe to IKIDA channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Functions of human skeleton. Now, if I say that an adult human being has 206 bones or 206 bones in their body. Now, all these 206 bones will have obviously some functions. Yes, one function which all of y'all can say that they provide protection or they simply give support to various muscles or tissue. They also bear the weight of your body. That's in simple language, you can say they hold the organs together. They protect the vital organs of your body. For example, your skull or your sutures protect the internal part of your brain or cerebrospinal fluid. They give definite structure and shape to our body. Now, long bones produce RBCs, especially the bone marrow associated bones produce the RBC cells, WBC cells or the fighter cells. Also, your skeletal system or your bony system gives that locomotory movement or helps in the process of locomotion. The functions of your skeletal system would include, now an adult human being basically will have 206 bones in them. The first or the basic function of skeletal system or skeleton would be that it provides support and bears the weight of the body, or simply you said organs. It provides surface area for attachment of muscles. Now this could be your leg muscle, your tendons, ligaments, anything. It protects vital organs such as your brain, your spinal cord, heart and lungs, and it gives definite shape to your body. Now when I talk about giving definite shape to your body, in vertebrate organisms or you talk about mammals, providing that flexible support or in the movement or in the locomotion, your skeletal system plays a very vital or a great role. If we talk about the long bones of the skeletal system, they basically produce RBCs or red blood cells in the bone marrow. Now, bone marrow is a place where RBCs would be generated through the process of hematopoiesis. Remember the process of hematopoiesis? That is. Now, skeletal system serves as a storage deposit for your calcium and your phosphate. Now, the calcium intake in your body or your CO2 plus intake as well as your phosphate intakes are deposited in the hollow structure of your bones, your leg bones, hand bones, etc. skeletal system in every individual or every organism participate in the movement. Now in humans it is different kind of movement. In animals it could be ciliary movement, amoeboid movement, anything, as well as locomotion of that particular organism, vertebrate or that particular ape, bird, anything. So students, in this part of the chapter what we did study was the functions of skeletal system, how it helps human beings or mammals, birds, apes, anything, or in simply vertebrates. I hope you are very clear about this concept. Thank you.